Right now, the Madison School District says changes are coming after thousands of workers say they haven't received overtime pay. We'll hear from one of those workers.
Also, Madison School Superintendent is speaking out after a deadly shooting outside of Beloit High School.
And health experts are closely monitoring a new subvariant of Omicron, what we know right now. Newsroom Now at 6 starts right now. For 7 weeks, about 1,000 hourly workers in the Madison School District haven't been able to get their overtime pay.
Today, the school district tells us that will change. Naomi Coles has the details.
This all started 7 weeks ago when a nationwide payroll software was hacked. Some employers resorted to manual methods of tracking base and overtime hours. Madison, based on documents I got from employees and their union, chose to pay base pay but no overtime until the hack was resolved. Today, the district told us they approved a temporary workaround to start paying employees their long overdue overtime.
This has been an issue since December 11th.
As overtime hours for Madison School District hourly employees ramp up, the pay hasn't followed. Nationwide, NPR reports 8 million employees have been affected by the Kronos system hack.
I know personally employees that have accrued about 100 hours of overtime at this point, and they have not been paid out for it.
We verified this person's employment at MMSD, but are protecting their name and voice for fear of retaliation for speaking to us about the issue.
Not only is it upsetting, but it's making employees not want to work these hours demanded by us, knowing that we're not going to be paid until an undisclosed time. It's affecting employees personally, not being able to make bills.
I spoke with a single mother today of two who is a $19 an hour employee.
Neil Rainford represents the union supporting about 300 affected employees in the district.
And she indicated that she had an $1,800 car repair that she wasn't able to make to pay for, and she's making payments on. She's $800 an hour behind in her rent, and this is really all as a result of not being paid her hourly pay differential and the overtime that she's earned really since a couple weeks before Christmas.
Already short-staffed, employees say they're at a breaking point without the extra pay.
And it's just pretty frustrating overall.
Plus, there's concerns about taxes being affected since the payments date back to last year. Now, another piece of good news for those in limbo. A district spokesperson tells me they have gotten word from Kronos, the software company, that the system could permanently be fixed in just another week or two. Meanwhile, hourly employees will see that overtime payout begin with their February 11th paycheck.
Naomi, thank you. Let's check your certified most accurate forecast with Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenalty.
Well, it was a typical January day today across southern Wisconsin. We had some sunshine. We had some clouds. No precipitation. The time lapse from the WIC SkyCam shows sunshine this morning. And then you can see those high, thin clouds starting to move in and thicken up during the afternoon hours. And that's kind of what we'll see for tonight and tomorrow. But right now, not seeing any real precipitation across our area. There's something showing up on radar, but it's not reaching the ground, at least according to surface reports. There's some snow up in northern Minnesota and then down to the south across parts of northern Illinois. Low temperatures this morning started out above and below zero. Here in Madison, we're just above zero at 3 degrees, but Lone Rock is at 1 below zero, and you can see Boscobel down in the Wisconsin River Valley, they were at 3 below. But right now, temperatures are in the upper 20s to around 30 degrees. These are near the high temperatures for the day, and these temperatures will probably start rising overnight, even though wind chills will make it feel about 10 to 15 degrees colder. By tomorrow morning, we should be in the mid-30s and look for high tomorrow of around 40 degrees before temperatures start to fall off later in the afternoon. But much colder air is on the way as a big winter storm passes to our south for the middle part of the week. I'll have more on that in the forecast in a few minutes.
Gary, thank you. The superintendent of the Madison Metropolitan School District says he and the rest of the district is grieving after a deadly shooting following a high school basketball game over the weekend in Beloit. Beloit police say a 19-year-old former Beloit Memorial High School student was shot and killed in the parking lot after the school's game against Madison La Follette. In a statement today, MMSD Superintendent Dr. Carlton Jenkins said, quote, "Although we are grateful and relieved all of our MMSD students were kept safe, these senseless acts of violence have a ripple effect impacting the basic fabric of all of our school communities. So far, no arrests have been made and no suspects have been publicly identified, despite at least 30 people witnessing the shooting." The Beloit Police Department giving more details on the victim of a deadly stabbing that happened Saturday morning. They say a 42-year-old Janesville woman was found dead with stab wounds, her death being ruled a homicide. The department is withholding the victim's name at this time. due to Marcy's Law. And a 34-year-old Rock County man is released from jail after the district attorney says it does not yet have enough evidence to charge him in connection with a woman's death that happened last Wednesday. As part of the man's release, he is not allowed to leave the state of Wisconsin, possess any weapons, or have any contact with the woman's family. Officers had responded to a report of someone getting shot on Madison Road, and there they found a 31-year-old woman shot. She later died at the hospital.
A man who allegedly fled the scene of a crash this weekend now faces multiple charges. Police say the 27-year-old was involved in a crash on Milwaukee Street at Stoughton Road. The suspect allegedly ran from the scene to a home on Belmont Road. Police said he armed himself with a golf club and a knife and made threats to police before he was arrested after a standoff. A 65-year-old woman involved in the crash is in critical condition.
Jury selection in Kenosha for a man who prosecutors say fired a gun seconds before Kyle Rittenhouse fired his. That's being delayed. It was supposed to start today, but the defense attorney in this case told the judge that their client had been intimidated by Joshua Zeminski. After some discussion, the judge raised Zeminski's bond from $1,000 to $14,000. Now, jail records show that Zeminski was in custody as of this afternoon. The charges he's facing are arson, obstructing an officer, and disorderly conduct. Jury selection is now set for March 28th.
It's now been 2 years since Wisconsin had its first case of COVID-19. The case, which happened in Dane County, wasn't officially confirmed until February 5th, making it the only 12th confirmed case in the country at the time. A year later, vaccine eligibility was on everyone's minds. And now, despite the recent spike in cases, health experts say we now know so much more than we did 2 years ago when it comes to navigating this virus.
That leaves me hopeful for a future where COVID-19 will probably never go away, but one that we'll be able to manage with, you know, probably annual vaccinations that protect against the most common variants. A day where we won't have to wear masks to prevent spread, a day where we won't have to avoid going to restaurants or out to, you know, events where.
Health leaders are still pushing for people to get vaccinated. More than 3.5 million Wisconsinites have received at least one dose of a vaccine, and more than 3 million completed a vaccine series.
And Dane County Executive Joe Parisi also noting the last 2 years. He says they have been challenging in a lot of ways.
A huge physical and emotional and psychological strain on everyone, certainly not just on county in county government, but across the community. And so, you know, dealing with everything we've had to deal with, trying to keep people on the same page, realizing how personal this has been for everyone. And
today, DHS says more than 1.3 million cases have been confirmed in Wisconsin and more than 11,000 people have died.
Local health department representatives say a new Omicron variant of the coronavirus has been detected in Dane County. It is the first case of what is being called the BA2 variant in the state. That new spinoff is catching some attention as it's becoming the dominant cause of COVID-19 in some parts of the world. But top U.S. health officials say there's no need to panic over the lineage. Mandy Gaither explains.
It's called BA2, a subvariant of Omicron, first detected in mid-November, now identified in at least 49 countries, including the U.S.
We're keeping a very close eye on it. Looks a bit more transmissible, but not necessarily more severe.
Like the more familiar version of Omicron, BA2 has a large number of changes, about 20 concentrated in the spike protein, the part of the virus that's targeted by vaccines.
Does it evade our immune system? Does it evade the immunity that we've acquired from Omicron infection or the vaccines? Most of the evidence so far, and it's preliminary, suggests it doesn't.
A report from the UK suggests current vaccines protect about as well against this subvariant as it does the original Omicron variant, with better protection against symptoms, an average of about 70% 2 weeks after a booster.
The only thing I feel pretty confident about is that we'll have more variants. We'll have future variants. So let's begin to prepare.
Health experts say no matter what the future throws at us, we now have the tools we need to be ready, including COVID-19 testing, widespread masking, and the best protection against the virus, vaccination, and boosters.
So whenever the next variant hits, we're going to be ready. We won't have to shut down schools. We won't have to shut down our lives. We'll manage our way through it.
In the U.S., roughly 100 cases caused by BA2 have been reported from at least 20 states, according to a sequence sharing website. The FDA is giving Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine full approval. Up until now, it has been given to adults under emergency use authorization. The approval makes it the second such vaccine alongside Pfizer's to receive the FDA's nod. A key difference is Moderna has never been approved or authorized for people under 18 years old. Still to come on News 3 Now at 6, some big names in music are coming to Wisconsin this summer. When you'll be able to see them in person.
Plus, a Madison diaper bank getting a major boost in supplies today. Find out who was able to deliver more than 100,000 diapers to them. Stay with us.
You're watching Madison's fastest growing newscast. News 3 Now at 6.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sheesh Raval with the Ortho Team Clinic at Stoughton Health. We hope you can join us for our upcoming event on treatment of knee arthritis and custom knee replacements.
Sick of waiting for your furniture to arrive? Menards has furniture you need in stock. Plus, you get a free rug. That's right. Buy any upholstered living room furniture at $299 or more and get a free 5x7 area rug. That's $149.99 in savings. Need a new chair? How about a sectional? A new recliner or love seat? Buy one today. Get a free rug. Hurry up. Get to Menards before they're gone. In store only while supplies last.
At no fault of their own during the bitter cold, thousands of Wisconsin residents in your community make the difficult choice between eating or heating their home. On February 10th, please join News 3 Now and support a day of warmth, benefiting the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund. 90 cents of every dollar donated is used to help those in crisis. Give the gift of warmth. For more information, visit kwwf.org/donate. A day of warmth, sponsored by Viridian Homes.
Guys, do you suffer from erectile dysfunction? Now there's great news. Peak Performance for Men will help you regain your performance and confidence naturally. Peak Performance for Men uses an advanced form of acoustic wave therapy, clinically shown to open up and regrow blood vessels, restoring normal and natural functionability where it counts most. There are no needles, no surgery, and best of all, no pain. Call now and receive an ultrasound, your initial consultation, all for free, an over $300 value. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
I love being an orthopedic surgeon because I can help people improve their lives. My name is Ashish Raval. I'm an orthopedic surgeon. My specialty is sports medicine, focusing specifically on the care of the shoulder, hip, and knee.
A local diaper bank is getting big help from a refugee site at Fort McCoy to the tune of more than 100,000 diapers and wipes. Lieutenant Mackenzie Hannon, who is in charge of the refugee site, reached out to the Village Diaper Bank here in Madison looking for a partner to coordinate a recipient for the thousands of diapers. That's when American Family Insurance stepped in, sending a box truck to pick up 15 pallets of diapers and deliver them to the diaper bank.
On a month-to-month basis, we're only able to really order enough product to service us for that particular month. So this is huge for us to have some backup supplies.
Village Diaper Bank estimates the total valuation of all the diapers and wipes to be over $25,000. All of these diapers will be distributed to the community, to families in need.
Well, the singer Halsey will be one of the headliners at Summerfest this year. This will be her first performance in Milwaukee since 2018. She was supposed to perform the last 2 years, but those shows both canceled. Tickets for the Love and Power Tour go on sale February 4th. However, for those who bought tickets for the previous show, they will be given a special pre-sale offer from February 1st through the 3rd. Meanwhile, both Josh Groban and Luke Bryan are bringing their tours through Milwaukee at the American Family Insurance Amphitheater. Groban will be performing on June 21st. He'll perform songs from his recent album, Harmony, along with his other hits. Meanwhile, Bryan will perform on August 5th. He'll be joined by opening acts Riley Green, Mitchell Tenpenny, and DJ Rock. Tickets for both shows go on sale February 4th. Still, more ahead on News 3 Now at 6, including an update on snowmobile trails here in Dane County.
Plus, the popularity of virtual currencies dramatically increased last year. So what kind of trends can we expect in 2022? What experts are saying to keep your eyes on. And a big warm-up is on its way, but it won't be here for long. Your complete forecast is next.
What you you see is important. How you see is important too. Get personalized care from experienced optometrists at Shopco Optical. Better eye care. You'll see. Right now, get 40% off frames with any lens purchase.
During Steinhoffel's Super Sale, have dinner on us. Get a $100 Grubhub, Uber Eats, or DoorDash gift card when you purchase some new furniture. Start with 35% off the largest selection of in-stock furniture and mattresses at the guaranteed lowest prices. Plus, when you take advantage of Steinhoffel's special financing, you'll save even more. So get some new furniture and have dinner on us during the Super Sale at Steinhoffel's. Relax, it's Steinhoffel's.
There's no telling what's in store with Wisconsin Lottery Scratch Games. It's Candy Blast, the sweet new $3 game that's chock full of fun. Use your symbols to match and reveal an entire game. Win up to $30,000. Instant Scratch Games from the Wisconsin Lottery. Odds are you'll like them.
Supply chain backlogs, inflation, agitation.
Here's an idea. If we make things here in America, supply chain issues won't be a thing anymore. That's exactly how we built the Bucks Arena, by having 80% of the materials come from Wisconsin. We did the same by paying higher wages. That's how you know, as your senator, I'll get things done. Raising people's wages, make things in America, finally stand up to China. I'm Alex Lazary, and I approve this message because it's time to put more money in the pockets of working people.
These are the faces that smile so wide at the friends and staff who are by their side, where life is lived with a feeling of pride on every bump of life's great ride that comes from the care that sweetens the air that lives in the house that angels built. Attic Angel Community, independent homes and four levels of assisted living built with the help of angels.
What you see is important. That makes quality eye care important too. Get personalized care from experienced optometrists at Shopco Optical. Better eye care. You'll see. Schedule your comprehensive eye exam at shopco.com or bring in your outside prescription.
You are watching News 3 Now at 6.
Crypto became more mainstream last year with the ups and downs of Bitcoin and the explosion of interest in NFTs. So what can we expect this year?
So far this 2022, Bitcoin's value tumbled almost 50% since hitting a record last November at nearly $70,000. We have a closer look at three trends in the cryptoverse that experts say they're closely watching as the year unfolds.
The cryptoverse is expanding in 2022. Experts say interest in digital currencies and blockchain, the technology that powers them, is exploding.
This year is going to be exciting. There's going to be a lot of opportunities to get involved.
Here are three trends experts say we could see this year. Number one, growing acceptance. Experts expect more people will likely invest in digital assets despite their volatility and extreme swings.
We've seen just in the last 3 months, prices fall over 50%. And throughout the history of cryptos, you can see 80% declines throughout various times.
Trend number two, embracing Web3. Web3 is described as the next phase of the internet, fueled by blockchain technology. Experts say it's a series of platforms and products where users control their own data instead of big tech.
Historically, when we've used the internet, we've always consumed content or given our information to platforms that have then captured all of our value. Let's call it selling our information on Facebook or YouTube. With Web3, these platforms are now being designed such that if you create value for a network, you're able to capture that in the form of a token.
And that brings us to trend number three, more regulation. Experts say lawmakers and financial regulators are likely to finally take action on digital currencies.
The space was unregulated. It was the Wild Wild West.
But the sort of reality of that is that the more regulation it is, the harder it is for there to be these crazy investment opportunities that I think we've seen make crypto so popular before.
For today's Consumer Watch, I'm Jen Sullivan.
So NFTs are non-fungible tokens, which are like digital collectibles. They're also expected to continue trending this year. Temperatures be much warmer tomorrow. Let's check back in with Gary for a complete look at your forecast. Gary?
In fact, those temperatures will actually start rising overnight. Three things you need to know in the forecast. Look for those temperatures to head through the 30s and will be up around 40 degrees by tomorrow afternoon before a cold front reaches us early in the afternoon. Then it turns breezy and sharply colder for tomorrow night into Wednesday. Temperatures will fall to just above 10 degrees by early on Wednesday morning and probably only stay in the lower to middle teens through much of the day on Wednesday. But a major winter storm will pass to our south. So if there's any precipitation, it'll just be in the form of a couple of flurries, mainly south of Madison. And then it'll be very cold for Thursday and Friday with nighttime low temperatures just above and below zero and wind chills at times down to 15 to 20 below zero. High temperatures will be in the teens. Taking a look at our snow, this is the end of January, and so far we've only picked up 16.2 inches of snow in Madison this winter compared to the average to the state at about 29.3. So you can see so far over a foot of snow below normal. Last year at this time we were at 32.8 inches, so we were a little bit above normal. That's about a 20-inch difference in snowfall this winter compared to last winter. Now as we take a look at Doppler track, you can see some flurries up in northwestern Wisconsin. This is not reaching the ground. This is actually warmer air aloft that's starting to spread in our direction. The air near the ground is still fairly cold, but there is a warm front out to the west of us, and that's what will generate a storm system to our south. Now, computer model forecast, you can see just how sharp this northern edge of the precipitation will be. They could be looking at anywhere from about 12 to 18 inches or more of snow through central Indiana and central Illinois, maybe 7 to 8 inches in the southern suburbs of Chicago, and then a sharp drop-off right through the Chicago area. Very little snow reaching into southern Wisconsin, except perhaps right along the Lake Michigan shoreline, where there could be some lake effect snows bringing a couple of inches into the Racine, Kenosha County areas. But you can see winter storm watches and winter storm warnings basically from Oklahoma and Kansas all the way northeastward to around Detroit, Michigan, and into the area around Buffalo, New York. This area here in Kansas and Oklahoma, temperatures right now are in the mid to upper 50s. They were in the 60s today, and they have a winter storm watch for Wednesday. So that's a big drop in temperatures. The jet stream will start dropping southward. You can see this buckle already starting to form in the jet stream. Moisture will start heading northward, and as these two air masses collide, that's where the storm will develop to our south and head to the northeast. But again, on the northern edge of that precipitation shield will be a very sharp cutoff, so very little of that snow will reach us. In the short term, this warm front out to the west of us heading in our direction, temperatures right now are in the upper 20s. On the other side of that warm front, they're in the 30s and 40s. We'll actually see our temperatures rise overnight. Wind chills right now are still in the teens with the brisk winds, but those winds are out of the south, and that's what will warm us up for tomorrow. But here comes the cold front. Notice the wind shift to the northwest tomorrow afternoon. You can see that rain changing to snow to our south and steady, heavy snow just up to the northern portion of Chicago. And again, those lake effect snow bands possibly kicking in to far southeastern Wisconsin as well. For tomorrow, look for a variably cloudy day. It'll be breezy and milder with a high temperature of 40 degrees. But on Wednesday, we only see a high of 17 after dropping to 12 in the morning. Just a couple of flurries to our south. And then after a cold end of the week, temperatures will be at or slightly above normal for much of next week with mainly dry weather.
Snowmobile trails in Dane County will be temporarily closed due to poor snow conditions. Officials say the expected warm temperatures also played a factor in the decision. The county's cross-country ski trails will remain open.
Halfway through conference play in Wisconsin, only has two losses in sports. We're going to hear from the Badgers on what they need to do to keep inching closer to March.
Now, First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection serves all of Dane County and the surrounding communities. And with our new location in Monroe, we also proudly serve all of Greene County.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection, a name you can trust when service is a must.
I was a Navy submariner for over 20 years. I spent a large portion of my life underwater. Service is about putting your country before yourself.
but Senator Ron Johnson uses his office to serve himself. Ron Johnson passed a special tax break that benefited his family's business, then cashed out of the company for $5 million. Ron Johnson has doubled his wealth since he's been elected. That's not what service is about. Tell Ron Johnson to stop voting for tax laws that benefit himself.
If you stutter on the phone, speech-to-speech is for you.
Hi, Nihada. This is Andy Smith, and I was calling to see if our home loan has been approved.
A specially trained operator revoices the conversation to the person on the other end of the line.
Hi, Nihada. This is Andy Smith, and I was calling to see if our home loan has been approved.
Oh, Andy, we have great news. You've been approved for the full amount.
To learn more about speech-to-speech relay service, go to wisconsinrelay.com.
Guys, if you're suffering from erectile dysfunction, Peak Performance for Men has a natural solution that can help you today. That's right. Stop wasting money on pill after pill that just masks your ED. Fix it for good. We can make the difference. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection is here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for all your residential and commercial plumbing services.
Monona Plumbing and Fire Protection, a name you can trust when service is a must.
He danced like a leprechaun, walked with goblins, turned into a turkey, and much more. Josh Brider shares a year of holiday memories in the 608.
And, of course, we're tracking a roller coaster ride of temperatures. That's tomorrow morning from 4:30 to 7.
We go. The 11th ranked Badgers took care of both Nebraska and Minnesota. Minnesota moving them to 8-2 in the Big Ten, meaning the Badgers are now halfway through conference play and know if they want to continue succeeding, they know it's about bringing that firepower and mettle they've been showing all season long and not letting the records get to them.
We weren't expected to be this good early on, and then as the season's gone on, we just keep winning games, and it's kind of just been thrown at us. I think recently, the last couple weeks where we've been top 15, it's been good. We haven't really wavered too much, let it get to us, so we just got to stick to what we're doing.
Continue to bring that grit and that fight every night, and not knowing we can lose on every single night, and we can win on every single night, so just knowing that and just trying to play our hardest every night.
And the Badgers flip the page on Minnesota, setting their sights on 18th-ranked Illinois. Both teams sit atop the Big Ten standings right now, so winner of Wednesday night's game will take over the sole number one spot. Tip-off is set for 8. Now, after the way things ended for the Packers, fans were hoping to see number 12 play one more time this season, possibly during the Pro Bowl on Sunday, but unfortunately, that will no longer be an option. Aaron Rodgers is not going to play in this year's Pro Bowl because of an injury, so Vikings QB Kirk Cousins will replace him. At this time, no additional info on Rodgers' injury or if he's made any decisions about his future just yet, so our Rodgers watch continues. As for the Pro Bowl, Matt LaFleur and his coaching staff will be heading the NFC. That kicks off in Las Vegas at 2. And speaking of coaching, Matt LaFleur said last week they were going to promote within for the new offensive coordinator. And so this afternoon, the Packers made it official. Adam Senevich will take over as the Green and Gold's OC. He replaces Nathaniel Hackett, who just took the Broncos head coaching position last week. Senevich has been the team's O-line coach for a couple of seasons. And in 2021, he also took on the role of run game coordinator. The Wisconsin women's hockey team finally turned their luck around in the state of hockey, but even after a tie and a shutout win against St. Cloud State, the Badgers moved down a spot in the rankings from number 3 to 4, but at least, you know, they're staying put in the top 5. Now UW prepares for a matchup with the St. Thomas tonight. It's the third meeting of the season. Badgers swept them back in November. Puck drops at 7:15. We'll have more at 10. Gary?
Temperatures are now in the upper 20s to around 30 degrees. They'll actually start rising overnight. Wind chills right now are mainly in the teens. Look for an overnight low temperature of 28 this evening, then rising temperatures overnight. A high tomorrow of 40, but then a big drop in temperatures into Wednesday and Thursday. Mild temperatures for the end of next week.
All right, Gary, thank you, and thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 6.
Have a great evening, and we'll see you back here at 10.